Hello friends, this video on environmental issues part 15 is brought to you by examfear.com. No more fear from exam. So let us see, how can we control the disposal of solid waste? So how can we control the impact of solid wastes to the environment? So what can we do about the electronic wastes? So how better can we handle the electronic wastes? Now, what are these electronic wastes composed of? It is composed of maybe a broken computer which cannot be repaired again. So what will you do with it? You just throw it off, right? So similarly, when your mobile phone is broken and it cannot be repaired, what do? You just throw it off. So these kind of electronic goods together form the electronic wastes. So how do we handle them? So what do they contain, in fact, first of all? So they contain a lot of toxic substances. They might contain some metallic wastes which are not biodegradable. They might also contain some harmful chemicals. So there can be a plenty of toxic substances in these electronic wastes. So how can we better handle them? Well, recycling of electronic wastes is definitely done everywhere, because different one particular electronic good is made up of different parts, right? So if we can segregate the parts, and then maybe each of those parts can be used up for some other purpose. So that is one way of recycling it. But now the question is, how do we recycle it? So that is also important. Now it has been observed that in most of the developed countries, the recycling of electronic wastes is done by equipments. But in developing countries, recycling is done manually. So we have to make sure that recycling process is being done in an environment friendly manner. What do we mean by that? Now, when I say that recycling is done manually, that means human beings are involved in the process of recycling. Now, when human beings are involved, so that means they are basically getting exposed to the toxic substances. So there are chances that they might get some diseases or they might get infected with those toxic substances. So there is a risk involved in that case. So what needs to be done is, the process of recycling electronic wastes need to be done with the help of equipment, so that it is only the machines which are involved in e-waste handling and no human being is involved in that part. So that is one way of handling electronic wastes. Next is community wastes. So what do we mean by community wastes? Once again, a quick recap. So sometime back we spoke about the wastes which come out of schools, offices, colleges, hospitals. So from hospitals you get a lot of stuffs like used syringes or harmful medicines, chemicals. So a lot of toxic substances might be there. So how do we handle their disposal? Now they need to be disposed, yes, but careful treatment needs to be taken care before disposing them off. Now whenever we treat the wastes, what do we do? We try to convert more toxic substances into less toxic substances and then we dispose them off. In that case, at least the harmful effects are lesser. So that is one way of handling the community wastes. Then comes the domestic wastes, that is the waste which goes from our houses. So how can we do a better management of domestic waste? The first thing that we can do is proper waste segregation. Like in our house, we might have vegetable waste, we might have paper, plastics, or used up electronic goods. So there might be so many different varieties of wastes, right? So what we have to do is we have to segregate them separately. For example, all the wastes which comes out of our kitchen, which involves food material, for example, used food, rotten food, fruits, vegetables, the vegetable piles, etc. So all those things should be kept together because they all can be treated in a similar way. Similarly, all the biodegradable wastes like paper or clothes, so things like that should be kept together because again they can be treated in a similar way. All non-biodegradable products can again be grouped together like the plastics, so that they can again be treated in a different way. So with proper waste segregation, how it helps is, now from every house they are segregating wastes properly. So in that case what happens, it becomes easier for the municipality to dispose the wastes, because when they get a pile, a big pile of vegetable waste, they know what to do with it. When they get a big pile of plastic wastes, they know what to do with it. So if that segregation part is taken care at the domestic level itself, then it becomes helpful. minimum use of plastics. Now, whatever is non-biodegradable, we should not use them much, because we all know that there is no way we can get rid of them, because there is no option by which they can be somehow degraded. Right. However, these days some innovative ways have also come up where some of these non-biodegradable substances can also be used in a useful way. So I will just give you an example where an innovative approach was followed by a company where they used plastics in building roads. So we will have a look at that. So let us look at the innovative way to get rid of plastic wastes. So how do we handle this? Because we all knew that plastic is non-biodegradable, so it will always remain there in our environment and it will always remain as a cause of pollution. But there was this person called Mr. Ahmed Khan. What did he do? He utilized the plastic waste to produce a new type of material called polyblend. So poly word is derived from polythene, that is plastic. Blend means mixture. So he creates something called polyblend, and what he did was, now basically, who was Ahmed Khan? So he was actually a scientist and he was also owner of a company called KK Plastic Waste Management Private Limited. Now around 10 years ago, what he did was, now there was a ban on plastics. Now if you remember, or if you don't remember also, so around 10 years ago what happened was the government had put a ban on plastics. You would have noticed that the shop stopped giving plastics and you were not supposed to carry goods in plastics. So there was a very strict ban on plastics. Now this person, Mr. Khan, his job was, he had a factory which produced plastics. So his business was all about plastics. Now when a ban was put on plastics, so obviously his business was not doing good. So what he did was, because that time his job was to produce plastics, so he thought of some alternative uses of plastics and came up with this new variety called polyblend. So he did some research and he found out that this polyblend, when mixed with bitumen, constructed roads of better quality. So that is, it not only was useful, but it also gave an added advantage. Like, research proved that this polyblend, when it is mixed with bitumen, it increases the water repellent property of bitumen. Now normally bitumen is used for construction of roads. You would have seen that small pieces of coal like structure, that is nothing but bitumen. So normally the bitumen has water repellent property, that is, it doesn't soak in water. Now when it is mixed with polyblend, its water repellent property increases all the more, so that means it becomes all the more better. Also the life of the road increases. So all these things were proved by proper calculations. So in this case, if you see, what is the advantage? We get better quality roads, because if, at least in India, if you see, there are a lot of places where the construction of roads need improvement. So in that case, what can be done? The road can be reconstructed, and in one way the plastic wastes can also be utilized, because in this entire process of producing polyblend, the raw material is plastic waste. So environment, so both the sides you have advantage. So one advantage is that the environment will get rid of plastic wastes. The other advantage is that we will get better roads of better quality. So this is one innovative way where we can utilize even non-biodegradable wastes. So this was about the solid wastes disposal. Now, when we talk about solid wastes, the concept of reduce, recycle and reuse is extremely important. So this is often referred as 3 R's: reduce, recycle, reuse. Now, let us see what it tries to say. In order to save the environment, these 3 R's are extremely helpful. So reduce, that is, reduce unnecessary usage of natural resources. So we should not waste energy in any way, because there is not plenty of energy everywhere. So we cannot create energy. It can just be transformed from one form to another. So we should not waste it. Recycle and use natural resources in different forms. Waste segregation is a must to recycle. For example, if we have any such goods which can be recycled, for example, let us say newspapers. I'll give you a very simple example of recycle. Suppose newspaper, you get newspaper every day at your home. Now once you read today's newspaper, is it going to be of any benefit to you tomorrow? No, right? You have already read the news. So now it is an old news. You do not want to read it again. But you, instead of throwing the newspaper in the dustbin, you can utilize the same newspaper in a number of ways. You can use it to maybe cover your books. You can use the same newspaper to prepare packets. So the same newspaper can be used to prepare carry bags. So the same thing can be recycled for different purposes. So that is called recycling. And third is reuse. That is, use the same resources again and again. For example, you purchased a bottle of jam. Now you ate the jam, so the jam is over now, but the bottle is still there. Now you have two options. Either you can throw that bottle away and again you can buy a new bottle of jam. The other option is you wash the bottle and keep the bottle with you, and next time when you go to the shop to buy jam, instead of buying a bottle of jam, now you can buy a packet of jam. I mean, you have that carry pack, right, where you don't get the bottle. So you just bring that and maybe you can store it in the same bottle, or maybe you can keep that bottle to store something else at your home. If you look at your kitchen, all the things, whether it is the pulses or the spices, everything is kept inside bottles. So maybe you can use the same bottle. Instead of throwing that bottle and buying a new bottle, you can reuse the same thing. So reduce, recycle and reuse. Reduce whatever is non-biodegradable, we should stop their use. We should reduce their usage. So these three things can actually help us to control a lot with respect to the solid wastes. So here you can look at some examples. Reduce, we should reduce wastage of water, wastage of electricity, wastage of any form of energy. Recycle, we should try to use products which can be very easily recycled. Reuse, as I said, newspapers or your jam bottles, or creating envelopes from used papers. So these are some of the ways by which you can reuse a particular object. So by doing all these things, you can actually reduce the amount of solid wastes. Thank you. Please visit www.examfuel.com to watch more educational videos with a better experience. Please do not forget to like and subscribe to our YouTube channel for latest updates. Thank you once again.